Hare Krishna.
Krishna Kumari.
Hi Krishna. Good morning, Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna,
Mara. Hare Krishna. Dingbai Nima.
Dingbai Nima,
Guru.
OK. 那 Vaikuntha 知音服务园一厅，为尊敬的 Vaishnava 奉献者，今天是 2021年 10月12日， 我们又荣幸地邀请到了圣 Bhakti Vaishnavinash Narasimha Swami Maharaj 给我们讲解今天的
Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prastaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namane. Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine. Visesha Shunyavadi Paschachadesha Tarine. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Sorry, I have a little bit of a cold here this morning. Okay, so we're reading Brihad Bhagavatamrita, and we're hearing Maharaj Parikshit described to his mother about the glories of the people in Vrindavan. And we're hearing about the glories of the gopis. And Parikshit Maharaj first of all glorifies the elder gopis. In a little while, we'll hear about the younger gopis. But first of all, Parikshit Maharaj describes about the special qualities of the older gopis, like Mother Yashoda and other ladies.
首先，而是大清描述了年长牧牛姑娘们的特殊荣耀，比如说亚修达妈妈和其他的牧牛姑娘。So
we have quite a long purport which we're going through here, by Sanatana Goswami.
Sanatana Goswami 就在这里给了一个非常很长的一个要旨。
Anyway, the verse was describing that that we should have no doubt about the destination of these ladies, that once they give up their bodies, that they're going to go back to Godhead.
首先, 在他们放弃躯体之后，他们一定会回归神手。
We all had so much transcendental love for Lord Krishna.
他们对于主 Krishna 怀着如此之多的超然之爱。
And they consider Krishna to be like to be their own son.
他们把 Krishna 当成自己亲生儿子。
So much so that Lord Krishna drank the milk from their breasts.
以至于主 Krishna 就亲自吮吸了他们的乳汁。
Now, Sanatan Goswami in his purport is describing that some people will become in practicing religious rituals, they become greedy to enjoy the results of the worship.
Sanatan Goswami 在这一段很长的要旨当中，就说到有些人举行宗教仪式，但是他们很贪婪的想获得他们这个仪式的结果。
And the result is that they may then become attached to sense gratification.
结果是他们有可能依附于感官享乐。
And because of their attachment, because they become addicted to sense gratification, they again take up more material religious rituals.
由于他们已经感官享乐上瘾了，所以他们就有可能从事更多的宗教活动、物质的仪式。
So by performing more religious rituals, they can get more sense gratification.
通过举行更多的宗教仪式，他们就获得更多的感官享乐。
So it's rare that people actually understand the advantage of following the cycle of the four goals of life.Which are called, they're called the Purush Arthas. The four goals of life are religiosity, economic development, sense gratification, and liberation.
In this world, 了解利用好这四项活动的人们的目的。是少之又少的。这四项活动是叫被称为 Purusharta 宗教、经济发展、感官享乐、解脱。
So the Vedas describe about the four Purusharthas. They guide us in how people can practice religiosity to get sense gratification.Or to get economic development, and with economic development, have sense gratification, and then eventually lead to liberation. It's described a lot in the Vedas.
Veda 经大量描述了如何从事于这些经济、宗教、经济发展，而获得感官享乐。
The problem is people become attached to.Economic development and sense gratification.
但是问题就在于，他们变得更依附于从经济发展，依附于从事感官享乐了。
And they forget the real advantage of following this cycle of economic development, sense gratification. It's meant to lead to liberation.
结果他们却忘记了。遵守这个循环，从事经济发展，获得感官享乐，最后目的是为了得到解脱，但是他们把这点忘了。
So the whole idea is that they will realize the advantage of this process, and that they will concentrate their efforts to get liberation.
整个的理念，他们就是应该意识到利用好这四项循环的优势所在，是以便于他们专注于这个努力，好最终得到解脱。
But unfortunately, a lot of people they just get lost, they get caught up in economic development and sense gratification, and they forget about liberation.
但是很不幸的是，他们迷失在这次的活动的循环当中，他们沉迷于经济发展和感官享乐，以至于他们忘记了目的是获得解脱了。
And that once they get liberation, then they will attract it. They may attract the mercy of a pure devotee who will teach them about the goal of bhakti, about the principle of bhakti.
一旦他们就得到解脱之后，他们就会得到一位纯粹奉献者，被一位纯粹奉献者深深的吸引。这位纯粹奉献者会教导他们bhakti 原则的目的。
And they'll realize that liberation is really insignificant.
他们就会意识到解脱原来是真的微不足道。
So people who are liberated, they actually all pray to get devotional service.
已经得到解脱了的人们，事实上都祈祷能够获得奉爱服务。
So, people who are candidates for spiritual advancement, they have to go through a lot of trouble to get devotional service.
取得灵性进步的候选人们。他们实际上为了达到奉爱服务要经历种种的麻烦。
Right. They had to go through all these preliminary stages of practicing material religion and then economic development, sense gratification, liberation.
他们实际上要经历前期的这些阶段，比如说宗教、经济发展、感官享乐和解脱。
And then get the mercy of a pure devotee to learn that liberation is insignificant and to concentrate on bhakti.
然后他们能得到纯粹奉献者的仁慈，他们就能意识到解脱是太微不足道了，之后他们就能专注于 bhakti。
So Krishna doesn't like to see his devotees waste their time in all of these things.
Krishna 不喜欢看到这些奉献者浪费时间。
So Krishna doesn't like to give his devotees all this economic development and sense gratification.
Krishna 就不愿意给他的奉献者经济发展，让他们从事经济发展和感官享乐。
So Sanatan Goswami asked the question. He said, "Well, won't this ruin Krishna's reputation?" If he doesn't fulfill the desires of his devotees?
Sanatana Goswami 就反问了一个问题。当 Krishna 不满足奉献者的愿望的时候，他会不会名誉扫地呢？
So the demigods answer this question, and they refer to Krishna as the giver of what is of real value.
神人们回答了这个问题，他们说 ，Krishna 是那位给予真正价值的人。
Krishna never gives his devotees what is not good for them.
Krishna 从来不把对奉献者不好的事物给予他的奉献者。
Just like a good father will not give his son food which is not good for him.
就好像一位真正的一位好父亲不会把对儿子不好的食物给儿子吃。
And the same way the Supreme Lord doesn't give his devotees anything which will cause them harm.
同样的方式，至尊主不会把会给他的奉献者造成伤害的事物给予他的奉献者。
So this shows that Krishna is actually the real well-wisher of his servants.
这就表明 Krishna 才是他 真正仆人他的仆人的真正的祝愿者。
So what is the best thing which Krishna prefers to give them?
那 Krishna 宁愿给予他的奉献者什么样的最好的事物呢？
And how will that thing actually satisfy Krishna's devotees?
而那样的事物又如何能真正的满足他的奉献者的内心呢？
So the demigods answer, they say,that Krishna gives away his own lotus feet.
半神人们回答这个问题说 ,Krishna 把他自己的莲花足给予他的奉献者。
In other words, he gives them pure devotional service.
换言之 ,Krishna 给予了对他的纯粹的奉爱服务。
And he gives this even to the devotees who don't want it.
他甚至把纯粹的奉献者给把纯粹的奉爱服给予那些并不想要他的奉献者。
Or they may have desires for things, they may want liberation.
或者是这些奉献者本来是想要解脱的。
So they didn't think that pure devotion was what they wanted.
他们并不把纯粹奉献者当作他们原本的目标。
But because Krishna gives them devotion, then Krishna takes away those other desires. By giving them pure devotion, all these other desires are forgotten.
Krishna 通过给予这些奉献者纯粹的奉爱，他就把他们原来的那些，使得他们忘记了他们其他的愿望了。
And because when they do pure devotional service, all their other desires are satisfied.
因为通过从事纯粹的奉爱服，他们所有的愿望都得到了满足和实现。
The devotee gets so much ecstasy in pure devotional service that he loses all interest in any other things.
因为他们从事纯粹的奉爱服务，获得这么多的狂喜，所以他们对其他事情都失去了兴趣。
So, even before getting prima bhakti, pure devotees may have asked something from Krishna.
在获得纯粹的奉爱之前。那这些纯粹的奉献者也许向 Krishna 要求了其他的事物。
They wanted to get something material, but it wasn't given to them.
他们曾经索要一些物质的事物，但是 Krishna 没有给予他们。
But because they got Krishna prem, they do not feel any problem. They're not feeling dissatisfied. They're completely satisfied.
因为他们已经得到了 Krishna Prem, 所以他们没有得到他们的物质欲望没有得到满足，这也不成问题。因为他们的不 they will be satisfied, right?
Yeah.
因为他们最终会彻底的心满意足了。
Yeah, they're so happy in the bliss of Krishna consciousness that they completely forget about the desires they had before.
Because they have already received Krishna consciousness, so many joy and happiness, so they have forgotten their previous wishes.
So Krishna is so merciful; he shows this kindness.Even to devotees who don't want it.
Krishna 是如此的仁慈，他甚至向那些并没有这种愿望的奉献者展示了他的好心。
Just like a father may see his child trying to eat dirt, so the father will stop the child from trying to eat dirt, and he'll give the child a nice sweet ball.
就好比 当父亲看见自己的孩子吃土的时候，他的父亲就会给他一个好吃的甜球来阻止他吃土。
The child may not want the sweet, but the father forces it on the child.
这个孩子可能是本来不想吃甜球，但是父亲强迫他的孩子吃了这些甜球。
And in this way, the child forgets about eating dirt.
就这样呢，这个孩子就把吃土这件事儿给彻底忘了。
So the father is giving the child real happiness.
就这样，这个父亲给予这个孩子真正的快乐。
So this is Krishna's way. This is how Krishna reciprocates with his devotees.
Krishna 就这以这样的方式和他的奉献者之间进行着交流，回报他的奉献者。
So Mukunda is actually the maintainer of all the members of the Yadu dynasty.
Mukunda 事实上是全体亚杜王朝的维系者。
And he is the spiritual master and worshipable deity.
他是灵性导师，他是值得崇拜的神祇。
He is our friend and the director of all of our activities.
他是我们的朋友，是我们所有活动的指导者。
So he will sometimes serve the family. He will serve the family of the Yadavas and the Pandavas. He will serve them just like a messenger or servant.
Krishna 有的是他，有时候就像一个信使和仆人那样，服务着亚杜家族，服务着潘达瓦兄弟。
He's just like an ordinary servant.
就像一个普通的仆人那样。
So, the people who get that kind of association with Krishna, they get the Lord Krishna gives them liberation very easily.
能够得到 Krishna 这种联谊的人们。就能轻而易举地获得解脱了。
But he does not easily give the opportunity to give service to him.
但是他却不会那么轻易地把对他的服务给予别人。
So Sanatana Goswami explains, he says, it's like Maharaj Parikshit.But he's explaining it to Maharaj Parikshit. He said, for the Pandavas and the Yadavas, Krishna is very absorbed in looking after them.
So, Sukadeva Goswami 就现在就像就解像 Parikshit 大君解释说对于潘德瓦和亚杜家族的人们，至尊主是非常，专注于充当那个主人的角色。
And for the sons of Pandu, meaning the Pandavas, he has a very special relationship with them.
而对于潘杜之子，主 Krishna 跟他们之间有着这种特殊的关系。
He acts like their servant.
他就充当了他们的仆人了。
Now, when Krishna gives bhakti yoga to someone, then Krishna becomes under the control of his devotee.
当 Krishna 把 bhakti yoga 功法瑜伽给某个人的时候，他实际上处在了这个人的控制之下了。
But Krishna still gives his bhakti yoga.To people who worship him.
但是 Krishna 仍然会把 Bhakti Yoga 奉献瑜伽给予那些崇拜他的人们。
So when we say Bhakti Yoga, we mean love of God, the highest level of devotional service.
当我们说到 Bhakti Yoga 奉献瑜伽的时候，就是指神爱、奉爱服的最高的完美。
And we get that level of bhakti yoga through association with pure devotees.
我们通过与纯粹奉献者的联谊，能够达到这种 bhakti yoga 的层面。
So Krishna never gives simply liberation to his surrendered devotees.
Krishna 从来不把解脱给予臣服了他的奉献者。
Because liberation is that's the goal for the impersonalists.
因为解脱是非人格主义者们的目标。
So to give liberation to his pure devotees would cause them not to appreciate bhakti yoga.
因为把解脱赐予他的纯粹奉献者，会使他们并不欣赏奉爱瑜伽 bhakti yoga.
Yeah, he wants them to know the glory, the Bhakti yoga is so much more important than liberation.
He 希望他们理解 Bhakti yoga 比解脱要重要的多，使得他们尊重 Bhakti yoga.
So Maharaj Pariksha has been glorifying the gopis and these gopis are.Like friends of Mother Yashoda, they're also like devotees, but they're not on her level. Mother Yashoda is greater than all these other gopi ladies.
Pariksit 大君呢，他就荣耀了这些勾品们。这些勾品们都是亚修的妈妈的朋友们，但是，他们并和亚修的妈妈并不在一个层面上。亚修的妈妈要比他们伟大。
Yeah, these gopi ladies, they fed their breast milk to Krishna for 1 year.
这些 gopi, 女士们，她们给 Krishna 哺乳整整一年。
But Mother Yashoda, she fed her breast milk to Krishna all for many years.
可是亚修的妈妈给 Krishna 哺乳许多年。
So their love for Krishna could never equal the love of Mother Yashoda.
他们，所以这些勾品们对 Krishna 的爱，跟亚修的妈妈对 Krishna 的爱不在同一层面上。
But we can understand if these gopis are so great, then how much greater Mother Yashoda is. Mother Yashoda is much more is greater than all of these gopis.
所以如果这些勾品们都那么伟大的话，那么亚修的妈妈她会有多么伟大呢？
So now Maharaj Pariksha is going to glorify the young gopis. He's glorified the old gopis. Now he's going to speak about the young gopis.
所以刚才Pariksha 大君他荣耀那些年长的勾品们，紧接下来他要荣耀那些年轻的勾品。
So he says the young gopis, for them the greatest pleasure was to see Krishna coming home in the evening.
他说这些年轻的勾品们，他们最大的快乐就是看见 Krishna 晚上回家的情景。
Because even a moment without his association was like 100 years for them.
跟 Krishna 片刻没有联谊，对于这些年轻的勾品来说，就像100年那么长。
Okay, so when they would see Krishna come home in the evening, after serving his friends, they'd see Krishna come home in the evening after they know.Krishna had many pastimes in the daytime in the forest with all of his friends, and the gopis would feel so happy to see Krishna come back to them in the evening.
当年轻勾品们看见 Krishna 晚上回来的时候，他们就知道 Krishna 在白天一定在森林当中和他的那些朋友们从事很多的消时光，所以年轻的 Gopi 们看见 Krishna 晚上回来都感到非常非常的高兴。
They knew during the daytime Krishna had done things like save the cowherd boys from the forest fire.
他们知道 Krishna 白天已经在森林当中从事了将他的朋友们从森林大火当中拯救出来的消失光。
But now Krishna, in the evening, Krishna's come back to them, so it's the greatest ecstasy for the gopis.
到了傍晚 ，Krishna 又回到他们身边。对于这些 gopi 来说，对他们来，他们是他们生命当中最大的快乐。
So.When Krishna would go off to the forest during the daytime, then the gopis would feel the separation from Krishna like a millennium.
当 Krishna 清晨离开他们去森林的时候，对于这些年轻的 gopi 就像一个世纪那么长。
But when they see Krishna.With his beautiful face and his curly locks of hair, then it's so much pleasure for our eyes.
但是当他们看到 Krishna 美丽的面庞，看见他卷曲的头发，他们感到内心异常的快乐。那对他们的眼睛来说是最大的快乐。
Now, this is described in the Gopi Gita, the song by the gopis. The gopis are searching for Krishna and they couldn't find Krishna. And they described like this.
This is in Gopi Gita,
So they curse the.At that time, they curse the creator that he's a foolish person, that he made eyes which blink, and we can't see Krishna all the time.
那时候他们就诅咒了创造者，说这创造者太愚蠢了，他竟然创造了眼皮，使得眼眨动着的眼睛，使得宫女们看不见 Krishna。
Of course, the days without Krishna didn't last hundreds of yugas, but it felt like that.
当然，当 Krishna 不在的白一天，他的时间并不像一百个 yuga 年代那么久，但是 gopi 们他们内心的感受是这样的。
So some gopis would suffer a lot from the separation from Krishna.
有些 gopi 们因为 Krishna 的分离，所以感到内心非常的痛苦。
And if they could see him just for a moment, then it would relieve them from all that pain.
倘若他们能有片刻看见 Krishna。他们内心的痛楚就得到了抚慰。
So every day was like that for the gopis.
对于 gopi 们而言，每一天都他们都这样度过的。
In the daytime, Krishna would go to the forest with the cowherd boys, friends, with the gopas.
在白天 ，Krishna 会和 gopa 他的牧牛童朋友们一起去森林。
And it would save the cowherd boys from the forest fire.
他会把他的牧牛童朋友从森林大火当中拯救出来。
And then in the night, he'd save the gopis from the forest fire of separation in their heart.
到了夜晚 ，Krishna 会将他的牧牛姑娘朋友们从森林 从分离之火的森林大火当中拯救出来。
So, saving the, both the gopas and the gopis from the fire. One was a fire of forest fire, the other was a fire of separation.
所以就这样呢 ，Krishna 把他的牧牛童朋友以及牧牛姑娘朋友们都从森林大火当中，拯救了出来。一个是，森白天的森林之火，一个是夜晚的分离的森林之火。
So for the gopis, their minds were always absorbed in thought of Krishna, and they were always talking about him and performing his pastimes.
这些牧牛姑娘的心意始终念念不忘 Krishna， 他们言语之间在谈论着 Krishna， 他们在上演着他的消逝光。
So in this way, they were always filled with his presence, they felt his presence by doing all of these things.
他们从事这些活动的时候，始终感受到 Krishna 的临在。
And they completely forgot about their homes as they were singing about the glories of Krishna. They completely forgot all the material situation.
当他们唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀的时候，他们把他们的家和物质的境况抛到九霄云外了。
Yeah, because they love Krishna so much, they just forgot everything about their family and all their relationships in the with the in the material sense.
因为他们如此深爱 Krishna， 所以他们忘记了他们的家庭，他们的关系，在物质意义上的家庭和关系。
So, when Krishna called the gopis to the forest for the rasa dance, at one point Krishna disappeared from them, and then they were searching. They were searching everywhere. They couldn't find Krishna.
Krishna 呼唤了牧牛姑娘到森林当中和他那跳 rasa 之舞，然后 Krishna 又突然消失了，牧牛姑娘就开始到处寻找 Krishna。
So they were wandering in the forest, looking everywhere, and they went right into the dense dark of the forest. Even there was no light.
牧牛姑娘开始四处寻找，他们就在森林当中漫游，他们甚至漫游到了森林的深处，漆黑、没有月光的地方。
So we would expect them just to go home in disappointment that they're so disappointed that they can't find Krishna. We'd think they'd just go home, but they couldn't even remember that they had a home.
这个时候，人或许会期待着牧牛姑娘会在失望当中回到家中，但是这些牧牛姑娘甚至忘记了她们还有家。
And they didn't complain about Krishna, about how Krishna's cheating them and hiding from them, but instead they continued to glorify Krishna.
牧牛勾品们，他们并没有抱怨 Krishna 欺骗了他们，把自己藏起来，他们反而荣耀了 Krishna.
Yeah, their minds were fixed on him, and they could only accept him. They could never give him up.
他们全然专注于 Krishna， 他们接受 Krishna， 他们不能放弃 Krishna。
And they were calling out to him, and they were chanting his name in Sankirtan.
他们在呼唤着 Krishna， 他们在 Sankirtan 当中唱诵了 Krishna 的名字。
And they made garlands and beds with flowers and leaves for him.
他们用鲜花和嫩草为 Krishna 制作花环，铺上这个鲜花和嫩草。
So with their body and their mind and words, they were always absorbed in Krishna and doing things for Krishna.
他们以心意、躯体、言语，全神贯注于 Krishna， 为 Krishna 献出了一切。
Even when they were in their homes, they were always focused on Krishna.
即便他们在家中，他们也全神贯注于 Krishna。
And they did their duties at home without knowing what was going on, without understanding where they were, what they were doing. So now they're outside, they're away from their home.So they don't give any thought for their home.
而现在他们已经来到了外面，所以他们根本就不想自己的家。
Krishna had abandoned them in the forest in the middle of the night, but they still went on singing the glories of Krishna.
Krishna 在漆黑的深夜放弃了他们。但是他们仅仅是继续唱诵着他的荣耀。
So the gopis were so anxious in separation from Krishna, they couldn't forget him at all.
勾皮们在与 Krishna 的分离当中焦灼万分，他们全神贯注地想着 Krishna。
And they would develop all of his personalities. They would assume the special features of Krishna would become, they would also become like Krishna.
这个时候他们的形象样貌就像 Krishna 一样。
Yeah, their minds were full, their minds had no fear, they were not afraid of anything, they were not worried about anything. And their speech became just like Krishna, they became very charming and spoke very nicely.
他们的声音言语就像 Krishna 一样有魅力。
They began to behave like Krishna. They would embrace each other and kiss each other, just as Krishna was doing.
他们这时候有行为举止恰似 Krishna， 相互的拥抱，相互的亲吻。
And their bodies even appeared like Krishna's.
他们的身体甚至表现的就像 Krishna 一样。
Just like Krishna has a special form bent in three places, so the gopis would assume that threefold bending form.
就像 Krishna 有着三度曲线，勾皮们现在也展示着身体的三度曲线。
So the gopis say,increased in their love for Krishna. It became, although they were becoming like Krishna, they never forgot Krishna, but they remembered Krishna more and more.
虽然他们外在的好，像 Krishna， 但是他们对 Krishna 的奉爱开始增加，越来越增长。
They were singing all the time the glories of Krishna. They were so absorbed in Krishna, they forgot about themselves. And certainly they never thought about their homes and the other things which were supposed to be there.
这个时候他们无疑他们已经忘记了家也忘记了家中的事物。
So Maharaj Pariksit said, just what kind of austerities must these gopis have done to become like this? They must have performed great austerities.
是的，说道，这些勾品们一定从事了什么样的苦行，使得他们拥有了如此的地位。
Because their eyes always see the nectar of Lord Krishna's form.
他们的双眼始终在喝饮着 Krishna 的形象。
That is the essence of beauty. It cannot be equaled or cannot be compared to anything.
那就是美丽的精髓，是无与伦比的。
So Krishna has so much. He has beauty, fame, opulence.
Krishna 美丽绝伦，他声名显赫，啊，富裕，甲富一方。
So when Krishna was coming to Mathura, the women of Mathura, they were glorifying Lord Krishna.
当 Krishna 进入马图尔城的时候，马图尔城的妇女们开始荣耀 Krishna。
Kamsa had sent Akrura to Vrindavan to bring Krishna and Balaram to Mathura.
Kamsa 把 Akrura 派到 Vrindavan， 将 Krishna 和 Balarama 接到 Mathura。
So the ladies of Mathura, they'd heard about Krishna.And when they heard Krishna and Balaram were walking in the street, they all wanted to see Krishna and Balarama. And they were all so happy, so absorbed to see the beauty of Krishna and Balaram.
Mathura 城的妇女们之前都听说了，耳闻过 Krishna 和 Balarama， 现在他们亲眼见到Krishna 和 Balarama 行走在大街上，他们内心无比快乐，他们全然专注于他们兄弟两个人的美丽上。
And these gopis, these ladies of Mathura, they say the gopis of Vrindavan are so fortunate because they can always see Krishna and they can always chant his glories.
Mathura 城的妇女们说，那们的那些女士们，她们是如此幸运，因为她们始终每时每，她们始终能看见 Krishna， 她们能始终唱颂着 Krishna 的荣耀。
So in the Vedas, it tells, you know, if you want to get benefits, it tells you what you have to do.What kind of austerities you have to perform to get different benefits.
Veda 经中就告诉人们，如果他们希望得到某种好处，就需要从事什么样的苦行，他们便能从中得到哪种好处。
But the women of Mathura, they say, we never heard of anybody getting the benefit like what the gopis got.
但是马图热城的女士们说，我们从未听说过有哪个人得到了像温达文的妇女们得到的这样的好处。
So we cannot understand what they must have done to have been able to achieve their position to see Krishna all the time.
所以我们不明白他们到底做了什么，使得他们取得了能够始终看见 Krishna 的地位。
They're able to directly relish the beauty of Krishna.
他们能够直接的欣赏到 Krishna 的美。
The city women, they cannot utter his name.But the city women, they cannot but they can only refer to the son of Nanda Maharaj, they can only talk about him as him. They cannot even chant his name because they have this respect for Krishna. They don't want to say his name. They will just refer to him as him.
那些城里的女人们，她们只能欣赏 Krishna， 只能用他这个词来指代 Krishna， 她们不说出他的名字，她们只是出于尊重，在仅仅的用他这个词来指代 Krishna。
Mathura women, they say Krishna is the most charming of all persons.
Mathura 的女人们称 Krishna 是所有人物当中最有魅力的一位。
Even for people who consider Krishna an avatar of Vishnu, they cannot find any avatar equal to him.
即便是那些Krishna 称为是 Vishnu 的一位化身的人们，他们也找不到有哪位化身可以与 Krishna。
And some persons, they may know that actually Krishna is the source of all avatars, but they can understand that no one is greater.
有些人他们能够明白 Krishna 是所有化身的源泉，他们能够明白没有人能够比他更伟大。
They know that.His beauty, his wonderful qualities are not created by anyone.
他们知道 Krishna 的美，他的品质是不能被任何人所创造出来的。
It's not that he gets his opulence or he gets his wonderful qualities just given to him for some time. Everything is all naturally his eternally.
他的这些富裕，他的这些品质，并不是在某段时间被赐予他的，而是自然而然的永恒存在的。
Uddhava describes that Krishna appears by his internal potency, yoga maya.
Uddhava 形容说 ，Krishna 是藉着他内在能量 yoga maya 显现于世。
And he comes in his eternal form.Which is just suitable for his pastimes. Even for those who are proud of their own opulence, even the Lord Himself in the form as the Lord of Vaikuntha. These pastimes of Krishna are wonderful even for those who may be proud of their own opulence, even for the Lord of Vaikuntha.
Krishna 消失光也是美妙绝伦的。
So the excellent, the super excellence of Krishna can only be understood in Vrindavan.
Krishna 的卓越 ，Krishna 的超凡，只能在 Vrindavan 才能被觉悟到。
And people who taste Krishna's glories, they will never be satisfied, they will never have enough. They will always want to taste it again and again.
品尝到 Krishna 的荣耀的人们永远永无厌足，他们只想一次又一次的来体验品味到他的荣耀。
So the glories of Krishna are very difficult to realize.Except for the gopis.
除了 gopi 们 ，Krishna 的荣耀是很难被觉悟到的。
Nobody can expect to know them directly. And only the gopis have Krishna under their control. So both Krishna's form and his personality are all ways of attracting devotees. The gopis always enjoy Krishna's beauty. And it said that the women that they had gone to watch the wrestling match, because Krishna was to take part in a wrestling match in Mathura. So the women were speaking like this. So they explain that the beauty of Krishna never leaves the gopis. The gopis never stop to see Krishna, even when he is away from them physically. The gopis of Vrindavan are the most fortunate women. But the ladies of Mathura, they say, we are not pious because we can see him only at inauspicious times. And the ladies of Mathura say, there's no way we can ever drink the beauty of Krishna like the gopis.
Mathura 城的女士们说, 我们没有办法像勾皮们那样来喝饮 Krishna的美丽。
They have the greatest love and the greatest respect for Krishna.
他们对 Krishna怀着最深爱意、最强烈的敬意。
Okay, we will stop.
好，那我们正课部分就讲到这里。
Are there questions?
Yes. 第一个问题是来自于Radharani. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada. 当我们在一天之内从事九项奉献服务，我们是属于被解脱了的。那当我们在一天里一段时间内停止了从事这些服务，我们立刻属于堕落的。 堕落的，对吗？谢谢。怎么样可以从不停止，从不堕落呢？ 感恩 Guru Maharaj， Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj。 During the day we perform 9 kind of devotional service. Therefore we are liberated. But during some period of time during the day we stop performing these services, then immediately we belong to the category of those fallen. Thank you. How can we never stop, never fallen, never become fallen? Thank you.
So you have to follow in the footsteps of the gopis. You have to be absorbed in Krishna at every moment.
所以您必须得追随这些勾皮们的莲花族 片片刻刻的都要专注于 Krishna。
Even the gopis are in their home, they're absorbed in Krishna.
即便这些 gopis 们在家中，他们也全神贯注于 Krishna。
You have to do it by chanting the holy name.
您需要通过唱诵圣名来做到这一点。
So Lord Chaitanya tells us in the Shikshastikam, Kirtaniya Sadahari, always chant the holy name.
Lord Chaitanya 在 Shikshastikam, 鲁德巴逊规的第三条说 Kirtaniya Sadahari, 恒常的唱诵主的圣名。
So if you're constantly chanting the holy name, that will protect you, that will keep you in Krishna consciousness.
倘若您恒常的唱诵圣名，那将保护您，使您本处于 Krishna 之觉当中。
This is the secret to keep yourself away from the material energy.
这个是让您摆脱物质能量的前置的一个机密的方法。
Keep the holy name of Krishna on your tongue. Sing the pastimes of Krishna. Chant his glories.
让 Hare Krishna mantra 就处在您的舌尖，唱诵他的消时光，唱诵歌颂他的荣耀。
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has given us wonderful songs we can sing, glorifying Krishna's names and all the pastimes.
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 给了我们一首美妙的歌曲，这首歌就荣耀了 Krishna 的名字 ，Krishna 的消时光。
Yeah, in the morning we sing Vibhavari Shesha Aloka Pravesha Nidrahari.Vibhavari Shesha Loka Provesha Nidra Hari Uta Jiva Bolo Hari Hari Mukunda Murari Rama Krishna Haya Kriva. We have to chant the holy name, we have to sing these songs. And we can sing also about Lord Chaitanya Udilo Aruna PurababhagiDvijamani Gora Mani Jage. When we sing these songs, then we will be Krishna conscious.
So, 刚才Maharaj 唱的这首 Vibhavari Shesha 这首歌就里面充满了主 Krishna 的各种消失光，他的各种名字。所以我们应当通过唱诵这些歌曲来歌颂 Krishna 的名字。同样还有歌颂出柴丹尼亚的这首《乌迪勒》，就是歌曲，这首歌曲，所以我们应当唱诵这些歌曲，使自己稳处于 Krishna 之觉中。
Yeah, and then you chant the holy name, chant the Maha Mantra.
除此之外，您可以唱诵圣名，唱诵 Maha Mantra.
And remember the pastimes of Krishna with the gopis of Vrindavan.
忆念着 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 和牧牛姑娘的 gopi 们的消时光。
Think about Lord Krishna going out in the morning, going out in the forest, in the forest of Vrindavan with all the cowherd boys.
想着 Krishna 在清晨和牧牛姑Gopa 和那些牧牛童们离开家去森林的情景。
So the holy name of Lord Krishna can save us from material existence.
So Krishna 的圣名可以将我们从物质存在当中拯救出来。
You want to always be in Krishna consciousness, you have to always chant the holy name. Keep the holy name always on your tongue.
您想要恒常地处在 Krishna 之觉当中，就需要恒常地唱诵圣名，让圣名处在您的舌尖。
Okay.
下一个问题。Vina, Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and all devotees. Please accept my humble obeisance. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. On Bhakti Shastra class, you said that it is better to use the address, please accept my humble obeisances, rather than Dandava pranam, and that Dandava pranam is more impersonal address, and please accept my humble obeisances is more personal. Could you explain this in more detail? Thank you. 云南的问题是, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者, 请接受我卑微的礼拜, 荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada。 您在巴克蒂沙舍公爱经典课程当中说到，我们最好用请接受我卑微的顶拜这句话，而不是用 Dandava pranam 菩提顶拜 Dandava pranam 这个词儿，因为 Dandava pranam 这个词儿是更加就是一种非人格的称一种说法。而请接受我卑微的顶拜这句话是更加人格化的，您能不能细体的来解释一下呢？谢谢您。
Well, we're following Srila Prabhupada. When Srila Prabhupada would write to devotees, Srila Prabhupada never wrote Dandavat Pranams. He would always like, please accept my humble obeisances. Well, Prabhupada wouldn't even say,please accept my blessings. When Prabhupada would write to disciples, he would tell them, please accept my blessings.
那我们，因为我们是追随Srila Prabhupada的，所以当Srila Prabhupada在写信的时候呢，他从来不说Dandava pranam，他只是说，请接受我的祝福。
But Dandava pranam, this is the abbreviation. This is everything is cut short. You want to make everything simple. And you cut down everything. Make it very simple. Just like sometimes people just say, Pam Ho, which means, please accept my humble obeisances. And they will just say, Pam Ho.
Dandava pranam,
just a
缩写是用短语，是想把一切都简化。就像有人说“汤后”，“汤后”就是，请接受我卑微的顶拜。这一句话每一个词的缩，第一个字母的缩写。
So, we want to try to increase our devotional service. We don't want to, minimize our devotional service.
我们希望。增加奉爱服务，而不是减少奉爱服务。
So we just say Dandava pranams. You know, it's easy to say. It's not what we were taught, not what we were brought up with in Krishna consciousness.
所以呢，就是。当 pranam 这词儿，并不是我们在 Krishna 知觉当中并没有得到这样的教育，我们在 Krishna 知觉成长过程当中也没有就是受到这个耳濡目染，并没有得到这方面的耳濡目染。
And we would say, first of all, please accept my humble obeisances, and then we would say, all glories to Srila Prabhupada.
当我们一开始说请接受我卑微的顶拜，随后我们就会说所有荣耀归于圣帕布帕德。
So obeisances can be offered with body and with the mind and with words.
顶拜应当是以躯体心意和言语来顶拜。
So the easiest way to offer them is with your words, simple words. You simply say some words.
最容易的方式就是用简单的话语来顶拜。
So we may say dandavats, pranams. Some people don't even know what these words mean.
有的人甚至都不知道 Dandavan Pranam 到底什么意思。
Dandavan means that we should fall down like a stick.
Dandavan 这个词意思就是像棍子一样直挺挺地倒在地上。
So when we say, please accept my humble obeisances, I think it's much more clear, and the meaning is much more clear.
所以当我们说请接受我卑微的顶拜的时候，这句话就使人家更意义就很清晰。
Pranams simply mean we fold our hands.We put our hands together, put the two palms together, and that's pranams.
Pranam 的意思是双手合十。
So I think it's better, I just prefer myself to say, please accept my humble obeisances, all glories to Srila Prabhupada.
所以对我个人而言呢，我更喜欢，就去这样说，请接受我卑微的顶拜，所有荣耀归于圣帕布帕德。
Next question.
下一个问题是 ，Novel 五，顶拜孤儿莲花族，奉献者得病和非奉献得病有什么不同呢？奉献者有病是消除业报，非奉献者有病是增加业报吗 ？So, I pay my obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. What's the difference between that the devotees got the illness and that the non-devotees got illness? Is that when devotees become there's a got illness, it's to eliminate their karma, and when the non-devotees, they got ill, is that they increase their karma?
No, non-devotees get ill, that is their karma, so their karma is being reduced also.
不是，非奉献者生病了。是由于他们的业报，那么他们生病也是减少了他们的业报。
And the devotee gets sick, we think this Krishna's mercy.
当奉献者生病的时候，我们就认为这是 Krishna 的仁慈。
Krishna's put me in this situation.
Krishna 就把我置于这种处境下。
Of course, we can also think that it is due to our past activities, past sinful activities.
当然，我们也可以这样想，这是由于我过往的罪恶活动。
It's an opportunity for us to intensify our devotion to Krishna.
通过这个机会，就可以加强我们对 Krishna 的奉爱服务。
When a non-devotee gets sick, then he laments and he thinks, this is my karma, my reactions, my suffering.
当非奉献者生病之后，他们就会悲伤哀叹，哎呦，这是由于我的业报，由于我的反应，这是使得我现在在受苦。
And their sense gratification is stopped. Their sense gratification is greatly restricted by their illness.
他们的感官享乐就停止了。他由于这个生病呢，他们的感官享乐受到限制。
But when a devotee gets sick, then he can take shelter of Krishna.
奉献者生病的时候，他便可以托庇于 Krishna。
And he prays more to Krishna and chants, can absorb his mind more on the mercy of Krishna.
就可以更多的向 Krishna 祈祷，唱诵他的名字，他们的心意就可以专注于 Krishna， 获得 Krishna 的仁慈。
So they have a different attitude towards illness. The devotee and the non-devotee, they will see the illness in different ways, very different ways.
所以奉献者和非奉献者对待疾病就有着不同的态度，而他们对待疾病的方法也有天壤之别。
Yeah.
下一个问题。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
哎，我能补充问一下，就是这里面的奉献者包括初级奉献者吗？佛家梵歌里面说，Krishna 会接管纯粹奉献者的感官，那 Guru 这里面提到，包括我们初级奉献者的感官也是被 Krishna 所控制吗？
Krishna Kumar Maharaji asked that because in Bhagavad Gita it is said that Krishna will take charge of the senses of pure devotees. So in this case, is it include the new fighters devotees that the senses are also controlled because you the devotees you mentioned that the attitude of devotee and non-devotee are different, so the devotees here you mentioned, does that include the new fighting devotees?
Yes, also the neophyte devotees.They may be neophyte devotees, but it's an opportunity for them to advance.
是的，包括新奉献者，因为这个机会也使得他们可以取得进步。
The advancement, the illness is a chance for them to become more introspective.And to elevate their consciousness closer to Krishna.
那这个得病的机会就使得他们可以内省，可以提高他们的知觉，使得他们更加接近 Krishna.
So we have to see how they respond to the illness. Some, if they lament the illness, then.That's not very good, and they're not taking it in a very Krishna conscious way.
所以要看他们对于疾病的反应如何。如果他们只是在那里一味的感伤，为这个生病感伤感化，那是不好的，因为他们并没有以 Krishna 知觉的方式来看待这个生病这件事儿。
So we have to reflect on the Krishna conscious philosophy to see everything as the arrangement of Krishna.
So we need to reflect Krishna 知觉的哲学来看待一切都是 Krishna 的安排。
Our illness is also the reactions given by Krishna.
我们生病也是 Krishna 赐予的一种反应。
There's nothing independent of Krishna.
没有什么能独立于 Krishna。Next one?
Yes.
下一个是 Chandra Vilasini Dasi.虔诚的顶拜 Guru 甜美的莲花族，请教 Guru， 如果我们拿家人的钱没用于做奉献服务，是不是在将来或者来世本金加利息的还给他们呢？如果拿他们的钱为 Krishna 做服务，如果没还他们，是不是就不欠他们债务了呢？感恩 Guru 的仁慈。If we take the money from our family, if you use If we don't use the money that we take from our family members and use it for devotional service, is it that in the future or in the next life that we have to repay them, repay all this money plus all the interest? If we use the money we have taken from them in the service of Krishna and we don't repay them, that then in that case we have no debt to them.
Well, if you take their money and use it for the service of Krishna, it's for their benefit.
如果拿家人的钱然后用来服务 Krishna, 那么这个就对于家人是有很多好是有好处的。
And you don't have to repay them.
在这种情况下就不需要还他们。
There's no karma.
在这种情况下是不存在业报的。
Rather, you're giving your family members the greatest benefit.
相反，这种做法是给家人带来最大的好处。
Of course, they may not agree. They may not like it.
当然，家人可能是不同意的，他们也不喜欢。
So don't tell them.
那你就别告诉他们。
Just sometimes you just have to do these things without letting people know.Just be indiscreet.
有的时候呢，就得不让别人知道去这么去做，就好避免那种分歧争吵，这种不和谐的状态出现。
Okay.
She said.If we don't use the money that we have taken from them, that we have to repay them in this life or next life.
If we don't use the money?
For devotional service, then is that in the future or in the next life, we have to repay all the money back to them plus the interest of the money?
Yeah, if you're not doing devotional service, if you take their money just for your own sense gratification, then you have a debt to them.
那如果拿他们钱用于感官享乐的话，那么就亏欠他们了。
If you take their money just simply for your eating and sleeping and mating and defending, then you become indebted. You have to repay debts to them. Yeah.
如果拿了他们钱，就一味的用于吃、睡、交配、防卫，那么就欠他们的，还要还他们。
So you should be very careful about taking money from other people.
所以在拿别人的钱这方面呢，就要小心谨慎。
It said Brahmanas will only take money from people who are very pious.They won't take any money from sinful people.
据说婆罗门只会从虔诚之士、虔诚的人们那里就收钱，他们不会从罪恶的人手中拿钱。
Just like food, we don't take food from anybody. We just take food from people who are devotees, who are pure, who offer the food to Krishna. We're not going to take food from other people.
就像食物，我们只会从那些纯粹的，把这些食物供奉过的奉献者那里接受食物，我们不会接受任何人别的人的食物。下一个，说那妈妈伊达西，顶拜玛哈拉，顶拜您和所有奉献者，请问咕噜戴。刚才讲到的物质世界的四种形式，宗教、发展经济、感官享乐、解脱，是主给物质世界的一个达到最高的梦 外的进化程序吗？是不是每个人都要经历这四种阶段才能达到奉爱服务？一旦成了 Krishna 的奉献者，就不要经历这些程序了。感恩 Guru Maharaj 顶拜您的莲花指。Is that the, you mentioned that the four kind the religion, economic development and sense gratification and liberation, is it a form that given by the Lord to attain the bhakti, highest bhakti? Is it a purification process that given by the Lord to attain bhakti? The first part of the question is this.
Well, we were explaining that that's one path by which you can come to bhakti. But it's a very troublesome path to come to bhakti that way.
刚才解释说了，就这只是达到 bhakti 的一种途径，但这种途径是麻烦，有重重的麻烦的。
Yeah, you have to work very hard to do all the things, to perform all the material religious rituals.
人必须要努力的工作，然后就方方面面的都要照顾到，而且还要举行那些仪式。
And then the economic development, to get economic development, that's also hard work. You have to do a lot. It doesn't just come automatically. You have to work for it.
还有经济发展，这个是非常辛苦的一件事儿。它不会自动的到来的，必须得为之努力。
And then sense gratification is also hard work. Although, you know, we think it's enjoyment, but there's a lot of hard work involved.
感官享乐呢，它也是一项辛苦的工作。虽然人们自以为在享乐，但是在这过程当中要付出很多的努力。
And then finally you may come to liberation.
然后最终一个人可能达到解脱这个层面。
Then if you're fortunate and you get to liberation, you may get the association of the pure devotee who can teach us about bhakti.
当达到解脱之后，倘若一个幸运的人，他可能得到一个纯粹奉献者的联谊，他就获得了 bhakti 奉爱。
So this is one way to come to bhakti, but it's a very long way and it's a lot of trouble.
所以这是达到 bhakti 奉爱的一种途径。那么这条途径是漫漫长路，而且是困难重重。
But you know, to get people to be religious, the Vedas describe a lot of things about how to practice material religion and how to get economic development. A lot of this is described in many places in scriptures, particularly in the Vedas.
那么维达经中就有很多地方就描述了怎样得到物质的宗教、物质的感官享乐。在许许多多地方，就许多经典，尤其是维达经就提到了。
Srila Vyasadeva wrote many books, and that's why he wasn't satisfied, because he glorified this material process of getting practicing religion to get economic development and sense gratification. So he was chastised by Narada Muni that he had not properly glorified devotional service.
Srila Vyasadeva 就撰写了大量的书籍，但他内心不满意，因为他荣耀了那些修习宗教、经济发展和感官享乐的方法、物质方法。那儿的牧女就为此就斥责了他，说他并没有正确的荣耀奉爱服务。
Yeah. Who asked this question?
Ratmala, Ratna. Yes, she continued to ask that is that everybody has to go through these four stages.
No.
Yet.
No.
不需要，不是每个人都要经历。Chaitanya Charan, Hare Krishna, 顶拜波队和奉献者，佛家梵歌。第三章和第五章都是讲业报瑜伽，两章之间有什么区别联系？业报瑜伽也是奉爱服务吗？ So in chapter 3 and chapter 5 both speak about karma yoga in Bhagavad Gita. What's the distinct difference and relationship between these two chapters?
Well, the fifth chapter speaks about karma yoga with knowledge. The third chapter, there's no real knowledge there. The knowledge was in the fourth chapter. So the fourth chapter, after getting transcendental knowledge, then one continues to perform detached karma yoga.
在第五章，就是有知识的 karma yoga， 而第三章是没有知识的 karma yoga。 在第四章就讲到了知识，在获得了知识之后，人就晋升到以有知识的从事 karma yoga。 他第五章也谈到了在气觉当中的 karma yoga。
Yeah, Prabhupada made the title of the fifth chapter Karma Yoga Action in Krishna Consciousness。So, it was a higher level of karma yoga. Haribol, Guru Mani?
Hare Krishna. Yes, just now my dropped off.
Yeah.
Yes, you mentioned that. In chapter 5, the title is Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness. And the next part, I miss it.
Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness. So, it's a higher level of Karma Yoga. The third chapter was just simply Karma Yoga. It could be attached karma yoga, still attached to the results of the work. And there was no real Krishna consciousness. The Krishna consciousness came along with the transcendental knowledge. Then there was some awakening of Krishna consciousness.
第五章的 karma yoga 它是更高层次的 karma yoga。而第三章呢，它是 karma yoga 是有依附的，从事 karma yoga， 它依附结果，而且没有 Krishna 之觉。所以当一个人他来拥有了超然知识之后，他就唤醒了 Krishna 之觉了。Krishna Kumar， 对不起，我的问题都没有了，您得念一下可以吗？Because there's no question here in my cell phone, so I'll ask Krishna Kumar Mother to read out the question.
Okay.
What about Sati? Krishna Kumar said that he also dropped off.
Where are the questions? In the chat?
Yes, in the chat.
Hare Krishna, what's that?
No, let's see what that
is. Priya, Radhi 的那个问题回答完了吗？没有，
没有，刚出来的。
那好，那我看啊，对，对，Priya Ravi 的问题，顶拜 Guru 的莲花族，顶拜翻译，灵性世界既然是全知极乐永恒的，那么在灵性世界，亚苏的妈妈知不知道 Krishna 是至尊主呢？
Priya Ravi, asked that since in the spiritual world everything is Satchitananda, then does Yashoda mother know that Krishna is the supreme lord?
Mother Yashoda only knows Krishna as her son.
Yashoda mama 只知道 Krishna 是自己的儿子。
She doesn't think of Krishna as God. If Mother Yashoda thought of Krishna as God, then there wouldn't be the same. It wouldn't be so pleasing to Krishna. Krishna enjoys the loving feeling of his mother, that his mother has so much care. She's always thinking to care for her child and to protect him. So Krishna enjoys that loving reciprocation of Mother Yashoda.
如果亚修的妈妈把 Krishna 当成神的话，那就情况就不一样了。亚修的妈妈这种心态更取悦 Krishna， 因为 Krishna 很享受他的母爱。亚修的妈妈总是关心自己的儿子，想要保护他，所以 Krishna 很享受这种爱的交流。
Now with Devaki, it's a different relationship. Devaki, from the very birth of her child, she saw her child to be the Supreme Lord. So she offers prayers to Krishna.
而在另一方面 ,Devaki 就不一样了。因为从 Krishna 一出生 ,Devaki 就把他当成至尊主，把自己的儿子当成至尊主，并且开始向他献上祈祷。
But Krishna enjoys more the love of Mother Yashoda. That's why as soon as Krishna takes birth, Vasudeva has to take child Krishna across the river and bring him to Mother Yashoda.
但是 Krishna 更享受 Yashoda 的母爱，正是因为这个原因，所以他一出生 ，Vasudeva 就把他带到河对岸，带到了亚修的那儿。
So Mother Yashoda's her love is the greatest love, because she can think of her child, think of Krishna as her child, even though he performs many wonderful activities, still she always thinks of Krishna as her child.
但是亚修达呢，只把 Krishna 当作自己的儿子，当了自己的孩子。即便是 Krishna 履行了种种的奇迹，但是他仍然是只把 Krishna 当成孩子。
We see Krishna after he killed the demon Putana, then Mother Yashoda was concerned to purify her child, and she did many different activities for the purification and for the protection of her child.
就在 Krishna 杀死女巫 Putana 之后呢，亚修的妈妈就很关切的要净化自己的孩子，她就做了种种的仪式活动来净化她，保护她。
Krishna was playing he was playing there on the body of Putana. Putana had revealed her form as a huge Rakshasi, and she'd fallen down dead, and Krishna was just playing on her body.
当 Putana 女巫被杀死之后，就现出她的原形，然后 Krishna 呢，就在倒在地上死去的女巫的身上开始玩耍。
So Mother Yashoda had to come and take her child, and she immediately got the urine of the cow, and she bathed Krishna in the urine of the cow, and then she chanted so many prayers.
小舍的立刻就过来抱起了 Krishna， 并且用牛尿给他沐浴，唱诵了种种的祷文。
So this is, you could say this is due to Yoga Maya. By Yoga Maya's influence, Krishna can enjoy this loving reciprocation from Mother Yashoda.
你可以说这是由于 Yoga Maya 的影响。由于他的影响呢，然后亚修达和 Krishna 之间就享受着这种爱的交流。
Yes. The Yoga Maya covers up Krishna's feature as God and reveals him simply as a child.
Yoga Maya 就覆盖了 Krishna 作为神的特征，只是揭示，只是展示他作为孩子的特征。
Just like we say, when Krishna is holding up Govardhan Hill, Mother Yashoda doesn't think her son is picking up the hill.She thinks it must be my husband. My husband must be doing it. Krishna couldn't do it.
When Krishna 举起高尔丹山的时候，亚瑟的妈妈就认为这不是 Krishna 举的，这是我丈夫举起来的。
Okay.
好的。下一个问题是 Suti Rupa Mataji 问的 ，Hare Krishna， 顶白咕噜和老师们，今天我和 Kadamba Mataji 一起带两位母亲去西藏朝圣旅行，请问咕噜，我们应该用什么样的心态，在吉祥的 Kartika 月把旅行灵性化？另外，还有就是如何以灵性的视域来理解？西藏的天葬仪式。
Suti Rupa Maharaj said that today, Kadamba, Maharaj and I took our two mothers. We begin our pilgrimage to Tibet, during this auspicious Kartika month. The question is that how to spiritualize our journey.And how to see the ceremony of the Tibetan way of they treat the body, the dead body of people by cutting it to pieces and feed it to the eagles. How to see the in a spiritual vision?
Yes. Well, you want to see the wherever you go, you want to see it in relation to Krishna. So the different features of the world, you can see them in relation to the universal form of Krishna.
您就可以看到，在任何地方都是跟 Krishna 有关联的。
Just like mountains. Just like mountains.
Sorry, 不同的地貌，它都是可以看成是 Krishna 宇宙形体的不同部位。
So the mountains are like the bones in the universal form of the Lord, and the rivers are like veins on the body of the Lord.
山脉就是宇宙形体的骨骼，而河流就是宇宙形体的河静脉、动脉、静脉。
So you want to try to remember Krishna in everywhere you go. So constantly chant the holy name.
如果您想无论去哪里都还能记得 Krishna 的话，就要恒常的唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
And try to hear also.About Krishna, take a book with you, and you can read.
去聆听有关于 Krishna 的事迹，随身携带一本书。
And when you see the rituals of the people there, how the Tibetan, what they do with the dead body, they feed it to the vultures. Well, this is their their culture because they don't have the same facility for taking care of the dead body. Like they don't have a Ganga there, they don't have the water of the Ganges to purify the dead body, to purify the ash, to take away the karmas for the dead person. So they just feed it to the birds.
那么如何看待这个天葬这个仪式呢？那么您可以这样想，因为他们没有那些便利设施来处理这个死尸，所以他们没有恒河水，没有恒河来净化这个尸首，所以来净化这个死就是死去的人们拿走这个他们的业报，所以他们只能把这个喂鸟吧，鸟。
There's another religion where they also feed the dead bodies to the vultures, and they do that because they consider fire to be sacred, so they don't want to put the dead body in the fire.
还有另外一个宗教呢，他们也举行了这种天葬，因为他们认为火是神圣的，所以他们就不把尸体投到火中。
Yeah, there's a group of people, and they're in India also. They have a branch. Originally, it came from Iran. They are called the Parsi religion.
嗯，所以就上面提到的是一种群人种，他们这么做。在印度呢，也有一个部落。 他们原本来自伊朗，他们信奉的是Parsi教。So
in Sijang, in Tibet, there's no, there's not much wood. They don't have a lot of wood to build a big fire to burn the dead bodies.
那么在西藏呢，没有很多的木头来架起这个火葬的这个木柴来焚烧这死去的尸体。
So the custom is to feed the dead body to the bird.
因此他们的风俗呢，就是把这个尸体呢喂给这个鹰，秃鹰就。
And that way, they don't have to worry about disposing. They don't, you know, like Christianity and Muslim, they build graves in the ground and put the bodies in. It would be difficult to do that in Tibet because the ground is so hard.
这种天葬的方式，他们就不用担心尸体腐烂。那么在基督教和穆斯林，就是伊斯兰教中，他们的风俗是把这个尸体埋在地下，但是。 在西藏这么做也很难，因为他们的土地很硬。Okay, so
be careful. Try always to remember Krishna. So keep the holy name on your tongue, constantly chant, and offer your food.
所以请。 路上要一路多加小心，要记住 Krishna， 让圣名恒常的处在您的舌尖，恒常的唱诵圣名，要供奉，把食物供奉了再吃。Using
going on pilgrimage, going to visit holy places, it is considered one of the nine kinds of devotional service. It is worshipping the lotus feet of Krishna.
朝圣也被认为是九项奉爱服务之一，那朝圣就是在崇拜 Krishna 的莲花足。So
you should consider that what you're trying to do, that your journey there is to worship the lotus feet of Lord Krishna.
所以您就要把您在那里的朝圣之旅当成是对 Krishna 莲花族的崇拜。
It's all Krishna, everything comes from Krishna, so the whole material world, the whole material manifestation is Krishna's energy. So certainly Krishna is also there in Tibet.
一切是发源于 Krishna, 物质世界是也是 Krishna 的能量的展示，所以 Krishna 一定也在西藏。
You have to concentrate on trying to remember Krishna.
所以您只要努力地专注于去意念记住 Krishna.
In Tibet, it won't be very easy to think of Krishna because everything is so much. There's not a lot of life, not a lot of nature.
Sorry, I didn't catch the meaning. There's not a lot of life, not a lot of nature.
Yeah, there's a shortage of natural resources. You know, difficult to get water, to bathe regularly there.
在西藏呢，想起 Krishna 是不容易的，因为那里呢，自然资源比较匮乏，水资源匮乏，在那里要有规律的沐浴不太容易。
Some devotees I know from Hong Kong, they went there, and they said that very difficult to get water. And when they did get water, then they found it was very painful on their skin.That bathing in water was because of the atmosphere, because it's so dry there, so high up, that their skin was not comfortable.
在就是曾经有两位香港奉献者，他们去西藏回来之后，就分享说，在西藏水是很稀缺的，然后那个用那儿的水沐浴。皮肤就会有疼痛的感觉，然后因为西藏是高原，而且气候干燥，所以呢，就是不是那么容易的事儿。
Anyway, you take care and try to stay in Krishna consciousness. Try to keep your consciousness of Krishna.
无论如何。要多加小心，要想着 Krishna， 要处在 Krishna 知觉当中。
And come back soon。
尽快的返回。
Okay. Yes.
Okay. 下一个问题，Radha， Priya Radhi。半神人心中的超灵和我们人类乃至动物、植物中心中的超灵是一样的吗？在没有启迪前，超灵起什么作用呢？
Priya Radhi asked that the super soul is situated in both the heart of demigods and the human being, and even situated in the animal and plants. So is it the same?The super soul the same?
Yes.
In everyone?
Yes.
是的，是一样的。
There's only one super soul.
只有一位超灵。
But he's expanded in everything.
但是这位超灵是处处扩展，它扩展到每一个生物心中。
Okay.
So what's the function of the super soul before we get initiated?
Well, the function of the super soul described in the Bhagavad Gita. You can read chapter 15, text number 15. Krishna describes. He says, from me comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
那么有关于超灵的作用，您可以阅读《薄伽梵歌》第十五章诗节十五。 Krishna 说我记忆我处在每一个人心中，知识记忆遗忘都来自于我。
So the super soul is situated in the heart. He knows our individual. He knows every individual's desires.
超灵处在每一个生物心中，而且他知道每一位生物的愿望。
So he facilitates things. If we want to remember something, Krishna will help us.
所以超灵的功能就是他协助。如果我们想要记住什么，他就帮助我们。
And if we want to forget something, and then Krishna also allows it.
倘若我们想要遗忘某件事情，他也允许。
We want to forget about all the troubles and all the difficulties we have in the material world, and we just think about enjoying, Krishna can allow it.
如果我们就想着忘记物质世界的种种麻烦、种种困难，然后享受的话， Krishna 他也允许我们有这种想法。
And Krishna, as a super soul, the super soul is also described in the fifth chapter that he's the overseer and he's the permitter.
在第五章当中是这样描述超灵的，超灵是监督者，他是允许者。
So he's watching everything we do and he allows us to do things. He will sanction things. We want to do something. Sometimes the super soul will tell us this is not good. And sometimes he will tell us, excuse me, sometimes he will tell us that certain actions are not good, and sometimes he will say certain actions are okay.
超灵他注视着我们的一举一动，他也允许我们去做我们做的事情。超灵他会有的时候会告诉我们有些活动是不好的，不应当做，但有些活动是可以去做的。
So the super soul is our guide, like our spiritual teacher. He's guiding us from the heart.
而超灵就像我们的指导者，灵性导师指引着我们，在内心指引我们。
But we cannot rely that our direction is coming from the super soul. It may be coming from our own mind. So we have to be very careful. What we say is actually coming from the heart. It may come from our mind. It may not come from the super soul.
但是我们也不能就是指望着就是说超灵就直接指引我们，因为有的时候是心意在那里指引着我们，所以我们要小心，就是我们就不能说我们所做的一切都是内在的超灵在指引着我们，它有可能是我们的来自我们的心意。
OK
下一个问题是Sudipa Sangama 的提问的，顶拜孤入的莲花族，顶拜翻译和聚会的奉献者。圣帕帕德在《圣典佛教瓦坛》第四篇第二章第二十二世节的要旨中说，遵守四月苦行誓言的人会在天堂王国享受永久的幸福。这种人极为仔细地遵守家居生活的各种规范，并且在这个世界当中说，这种人不知道有永恒极乐的灵性生活，非常的依恋物质生活。那么请问古鲁玛拉者，我们伊斯康的奉献者向往的是灵性生活和回归灵性家园，回归守神。那么帕帕德的这个要旨让我感觉到我并不需要遵守四月苦行，不知道这样的理解对不对。
Sukhita Sangamaji is relating a report from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Chapter 2, Verse 22. It is said that those who follow the Chatumasa vows they will enjoy eternal happiness in the heaven, the kingdom of heaven. These kind of people, they will follow various kind of regulative principle of family life. In this verse, it is said that these people, they don't know that there is a spiritual life that is eternal, full of bliss. Therefore, they are very attached to the material happiness. So the question that Gurmara, the devotee of our ISKCON, they are hankering for spiritual life and spiritual world. Their destination is to go back home, back to Godhead. But yet, after reading the purport of Srila Prabhupada, I feel that there's no need for us to follow the Chatumasa austerity. I don't know whether this understanding is right or wrong.
Well, there's a need to follow the instructions of the spiritual teacher.
You should follow the instruction of the spiritual teacher, right?
Yes.
那您就应该遵守灵性导师的训示。
So if the spiritual teacher said you should follow Chaturmasya, you should follow.
灵性导师说您当遵守四月苦行，所以您当遵守四月苦行。
We don't follow Chaturmasya in a very strict way. We have a very slight, very small application of the principles of Chaturmasya. Of course, the real purpose of Chaturmasya is to increase our remembrance of Krishna. We're not thinking to go to heaven, we're not thinking to enjoy the material world. But still we should do Chaturmasya, we should accept some austerity.
尽管如此，我们仍然应当去遵守四月苦行，去从事一些苦行。
Because austerity is purifying.
因为苦行能够净化人。
Okay.
Okay, last one. 最后一个问题了啊。我把他 Tom, Hare Krishna, 顶拜呼噜和奉献者的莲花族。接着前面那个问题就是关于Krishna 知觉的业报瑜伽和妨碍瑜伽当中的和妨碍瑜伽有什么区别？
This question is related to the previous question about the Karma Yoga in chapter 3 and 5. The Karma Yoga with Krishna consciousness and Bhakti Yoga. Well, what's the difference between the two? I'm a little confused, messed up with the two. About the Karma Yoga in Krishna consciousness and Bhakti Yoga.
What's the difference between Karma Yoga and Bhakti Yoga?
Yes. Karma Yoga in Krishna consciousness.
Well, Karma Yogi, they're attached to work. They're attached to working in a particular way.
那些业报瑜伽师，他们依附于以特定的方式从事活动。
But they will surrender some portion of the results of their work to Krishna.
但是他们会把他们的一部分工作成果献给，交给 Krishna。
But in Bhakti Yoga, the devotee surrenders first, and he will do anything for Krishna.
但是在奉爱瑜伽 一个人，他首先他一上来就臣服了，然后他所作所为，他一切都是为了Krishna 来从事的。
But Karma Yogi, he's thinking, he identifies with a particular kind of work. He's attached to working in a particular way.
但是夜报瑜伽，其实他是认同于某种工作的，他就特别依附于，一定要以某种方式去活动。
Just like Arjuna is a Kshatriya, he has to fight. He has a nature.
就像而朱呢，他是一个沙地利，他必须要作战，这是他的天性。
So fight for Krishna, do it for Krishna.
所以，那就为 Krishna 而作战吧。
No, people like to work. You like to have a job and work and make money. Okay, work for Krishna.
人们喜欢工作，喜欢赚钱。那没问题，那你为 Krishna 去赚钱去工作吧。
And then after working for, then we surrender the result to Krishna.
在工作之后呢，我们把工作的活动的成果献给，臣服给 Krishna.
But Bhakti Yoga, we first surrender.
但是在奉爱瑜伽当中，我们就首先就臣服了。
And then do whatever Krishna wants us to do.
然后我们去做 Krishna, 不论 Krishna 想让我们做什么，从事什么，我们就去做什么。
Just like a Bhakti Yogi, he understands everything is Krishna's. He gives everything to Krishna.
就一位奉爱瑜伽师，他意识到一切都属于 Krishna, 所以他把一切都给予 Krishna.
Karma Yogi thinks I'm giving.To Krishna.
而一个夜报瑜伽师，他认为，我在给予，是我给的 Krishna， 这个是我给的。
He's thinking, I worked, I made this money, now I'm giving this to Krishna.
他认为我去工作了，然后这钱是我给的，这个是我在给 Krishna.
But Bhakti Yogi knows it's all Krishna's, it's not mine.
但是一个奉爱瑜伽师，他意识到一切都属于 Krishna 的，没有什么属于我。
OK。
好的。那个 Radha Madhava Madhaji， 您的问题，我觉得您去读那个快乐源泉就可以了啊。然后后面还有问题跟本次课程也不太相关了。咕噜已经讲了两个小时了啊，然后。有一些感冒，所以今天我们的课程就到这里了。非常感谢布鲁马哈拉这个讲课 ，Hare Krishna。
OK， 我们感谢 Guru Mani， 给我们翻译，感谢 Sati Jujar， 感谢 Krishna Kumari Jujar， 感谢所有的奉献者聆听 T1， 祝福你们长寿快乐，万事如意，传教顺利。Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.